I gotta go find Macho Man. I miss him, man. But what the?
This is just.
Oh my God! That can't be. No freaking way. Is that? That's gotta be one of Macho's strippers. That looks like.
Yeah.
Looks like Miss Parker. Damn, man. It is. Lance is gonna be pissed. Hey, Miss Parker, what are you wearing over there? Look pretty good, just say.
You fucking talking to me?
What the fuck?
Yeah, Damien thought the same thing.
Ah! What? What the hell? Ah!
I'm sorry.
Jesus. It felt all too real.
What's going on, guys? We are here for SoCal Showdown's pre-show. Of course, alongside me, as usual, is Evan Rude. We've got a couple more guest commentators here tonight, though. Of course, Evan Rude's buddy Jay Carter and Lance. They will be with us later tonight. But right now, the pre-show is opening up with Liv Morgan going one-on-one with Angel Watson. This is set to be an interesting matchup here as Chowie rings the bell on the pre-show.
I see lots of white. Lots and lots of white.
Yeah, the arena here tonight trying to give a resemblance of a beach here. So of course we've got beach sand as the floor out here. Not very conventional, but it's interesting nonetheless. And right there, right here, there's Liv Morgan, and she's looking to follow up with a Hurricanrana on Angel Watson.
Beautiful Hurricanrana there by Liv Morgan.
Yeah, these two are going to lock back up here. Angel Watson in control, takes Liv Morgan over her shoulders, going to press her down into a seated reverse lock there. Now going to power back up and take her over into a chin lock. Good chain wrestling here between the two.
Both of these women are really agile, I can definitely tell.
Yeah, they're transitioning here back and forth in between. Good chain wrestling. Angel Watson gets the advantage on Liv Morgan. Of course, this is Liv Morgan's UWA debut here. Going one-on-one on the pre-show with Angel Watson, who has a 3-0 record currently in UWA.
What a knee that was by Watson a few seconds ago.
Yeah, Angel trying to rearrange her face there, trying to rearrange the face of Liv Morgan. Man, I'm telling you, last night I had a weird-ass dream, and it's too bad neither one of these were in it, because the dream would have been a lot more sustainable. But I nonetheless went for a cover there to Angel Watson on Liv Morgan.
Oh, I'm sure it was terrible.
Yeah, it involved a snake and a few other things, but nonetheless, Angel Watson driving her knees into the face of Liv Morgan.
Picks her up. Slammed her right back down. Angel Watson here is just dominating the ball.
Yeah, we're going to look for a trifecta here. Back suplex into a, looks like a German. Did not release, holds the grip. Now she's looking for a version of her own Three Amigos as she connects with the rolling suplex. Speaking of rolling, Liv Morgan just rolled the hell out.
Super kick.
Right on that jaw there from Angel Watson to Liv Morgan. Watson gonna look to follow up here on Liv. Gonna look for another roundhouse kick, but looks like Liv Morgan's able to scout it.
Is she laughing?
Something like that.
I don't know why she'd be laughing. She's really not. She was in control for a few seconds, but now it's back to Angel Watson here.
Yeah, Watson taking her down with a flashback. Angel Watson in firm control. While we're speaking of control and the condition of the competitors, how's your knee, Evan Rude?
I don't want to talk about that right now, man.
All right. I'm guessing it's not 100% then, but we'll figure that out later for the SoCal Rumbles. Angel Watson with a split-legged leg drop across the face of Liv Morgan into the cover. Could be Dunzo there, but no, Liv Morgan's able to stay alive at two. Angel in
control.
Yeah, she's in control here. Of course, you've got to assume Angel Watson has the advantage in this match. Oh, God, I'm out.
Oh, she caught her!
I was going to ask you who you think is going to win, but I think it's already over.
This has got to be it.
The fall from grace right there from Angel Watson is what she used to pick up the win on Lance's Mary Mayhem Part Dwarf. And cover here, and Charlie counts the three. Angel Watson defeats Liv Morgan in impressive fashion with that pop-up fall from grace.
There is your winner, Angel Watson.
You will definitely be seeing more of this Angel Watson shirt.
That was an impressive finish. Of course, she calls it fall from grace, which is very fitting considering the name of Angel Watson. And she is filled with doggy meat. But nonetheless, we are moving on.
It's got to be on. They're here. This is happening quicker than I anticipated.
What the hell are you talking about?
Remember that amulet I gave myself last month? You're about to find out the purpose that that serves in this battle.
Here we go.
You had me, but guess again. Come SoCal, I claim your soul, you son of a bitch.
The world has always labeled me a nihilist, cause I find the beauty in the violence. My mind is always loudest in the silence. A living contradiction. Every single day stranger than fiction. I'm afflicted by my own affliction.
And you guys are seeing the preview for the SoCal Showdown Arena Deathmatch, the second ever deathmatch in UWA history that will take place later tonight as Christian Reed goes head-to-head with Max Fatal in a deathmatch. The loser, of course, of the match will be murdered. Only way to win is pinfall, submission, or liberty to kill your opponent.
And what a show that's going to be.
Yes, but first things first, the SoCal Rumble is up next as 22 competitors look to fight for the UWA Intercontinental title case to go on to face Brody Lee later tonight on the main card. And introducing first, of course, accompanied by freshly squeezed Orange Cassidy, it is none other than his best friend, Parker. And well, Parker sucks, but that's beside the point. Evan Reed, take it over. Yes, Parker does suck.
Oh my god.
Everyone hates Parker. I mean, except for Orange.
I can't remember why these two got together. Maybe they're losing streak. It makes sense to me. It does.
Funny enough, Orange Cassidy has only ever had one match here in UWA, and it was, in fact, a loss to Fatal and Lance. Back at Lance's Mary Mayhem Part Dwarf, he has yet to have a second competition, a second match here in UWA.
Well, who's competing? Is it Orange, or is it...
It might be both of them because they're both in the ring. I'm not exactly sure. It looks like it's going to be Parker, I guess. But,
Fuck you, Parker.
Oh, fuck. And, arena number two.
Rest in peace.
Is the Murderhawk monster, Lance Archer. And as he says, everybody dies. That definitely includes Parker Sucks.
My knee really hurts right now just watching this.
Yeah,
he really hurts. Oh, man.
I wonder if Parker's about to try to make that same excuse here as the Murderhawk monster marches his way down to the ring. Of course, he's being controlled, being led, being advised by the snake, of course, Jake the Snake Roberts. And,
Good word.
I was trying to find the right word. It took a few seconds. Lance Archer's
okay,
a bit intimidating.
I don't think anybody tells Lance what the fuck to do.
That
nobody trusts Lance
point.
What to do. He does whatever the hell he wants. No pun intended.
No. God, and right there.
What a big boot.
Right off the start, Parker tried to run at Lance Archer. That's probably the dumbest thing he could have done in that situation. And I don't
think... Is he already going out? What?
Oh, no, God. No, no. Oh, God. Archer. Oh, jeez.
What the fuck? What the fuck?
He just passed. Well, oh, God. And in comes Vaquero. Vaquero's trying to enter the match, too. Oh, well.
There he goes. 2-0.
Two eliminations instant. Oh, no. Oh, my God. The music of the former Rising Stars champion, Alexander Hammerstone. Hammerstone's back.
Well, he doesn't really stand a chance against Lance. He might as well eliminate himself.
We'll see about that. Hammerstone, the former longest-reigning Rising Stars champion. He was a force to be reckoned with in 2017. That was a few years ago, though, and Hammerstone finally making his return here. He's never faced anyone quite like Lance Archer, though. But Lance Archer, as far as I'm concerned, never faced anyone quite like Hammerstone. This is going to be an interesting matchup, in my opinion.
I know it's like
he's related
to Scott Steiner.
Maybe he is. Would that make him an honorary SVU alumni? Or at least get him an opportunity to become the new sergeant.
Maybe so. Ask SVU about that.
We only know a couple SVU members right now, of course, since the passing of Scott Steiner and Dwight.
Now, maybe Drew?
Now, yeah, Drew, of course, has taken over as chief. We don't know where Ice-T is. We haven't seen him since the bombing. His body was not recovered, though, so we're assuming he's not dead. But, I mean, we don't really know, to be fair.
I'll put that on my list to ask Drew.
Yeah, of course, we've seen the return of Flip Gordon, who was undercover all this season. So Flip, of course, back in SBU, he's taking over as the new lieutenant for the group, taking Scott Steiner's position. But right now, it's just Drew and Flip holding down the fort for SBU, and Hammerstone right away with a kick to the midsection of Lance Archer. He's going to try to rearrange the midsection of Archer early on.
Oh. Knee straight to the ribcage, it looked like there.
Yeah, that's
Lance Archer.
It's one of Hammerstone's go-to maneuvers, and now he's military pressing Archer.
Oh.
Hammerstone,
he's
I don't think...
He's throwing Archer around this ring like he's nothing. Just like a piece of garbage.
Well, take into account, Hammerstone knew who he was coming out to face. Lance Archer didn't until the music hit. And he ducked the big boot. I mean, to be fair, Archer still might not know who he's facing. He might not know who Hammerstone is, to be fair. Right there, shots to the back of the spine.
Let's see who's next. Could it be me or could it not be me? Never.
Next entrant here is...
Speaking of Drew!
We were just talking about him. It's the chief of the Severe Violence Unit. This is Chief Drew. No, I did not.
I sure myself did not.
Of course, the man running the show tonight, of course, is our buddy Ben. Vincent Bennett over there. He is running the show. Now it is SoCal Showdown hosted by Ben. As you see at the start of the show in the thumbnail. Nonetheless, now Drew's gotten in the ring here. Drew will be in the ring with Lance Archer and Hammerstone. Oh, God. Archer with a knee right to the face immediately.
He better already be gone here.
Yeah, Archer trying to get a quick third elimination here on Drew, on Chief Drew.
Not happening.
Got to make sure and put the Chief in there. He is the Chief of this. Oh, God. He's about... Oh, God.
No!
He
says,
oh, no.
Oh, okay. Right on the back. He landed right on his back. That's got to hurt.
I was wondering if Drew was strong enough to get Archer up over the ropes like that, and I think we got our answer there. We've seen Lance Archer at the start of the match just pounce Parker out of the ring, which might arguably be the funniest thing I've ever seen.
That was so incredible.
And Archer's a beast, and then of course chokeslamming Vaquero out of the ring too, took out our table for this evening. And now the next entrant, this biggest fan in UWA history, it is Real Fake Batman. As our good buddy Eric would say, straight from Comic-Con, out comes real fake Batman.
I have no words.
We still don't know the identity of real fake Batman. I don't know if we ever will.
Probably not. Because he's about to die. Look at the size of him between him and about everybody else.
My god, real fake Batman just took Archer down off his
Jesus.
Feet.
Jesus!
And I know Jake Roberts ain't feeling this right now. He's not about to look to have his client buried here by a freaking RF Batman.
Before RF Batman even came out, it looked like Archer and the other guy in hand was going to team up on Drew.
Hammerstone. And right there, a back elbow to the face of Drew. Went to follow up. Nice counter there from Hammer. Yeah, your boy Hammer taking it to...
Wait a minute. Oh, no. Don't tell me it's him.
The clock's ticking down.
Don't tell me this is it.
We haven't seen my old buddy in forever.
Is this who we think it is?
For multiple reasons. Whether you want to hate him or not, he's been off filming.
It
is Marty Skrull. The villain is back.
Welcome back, Marty Skrull.
I guess the SJWs are going to have to suck it. And of course, Marty was off filming with Bobby Wade. Robert Wade, if you will. They were off filming Bobby Wade's new movie. And of course, Wade we are going to see back here later tonight as well. Just want to get that out there. Bobby Wade finally returning. We haven't seen him since this Universal Rumble last year. What the hell is... Okay, I thought Archer was about to throw him out.
I did too.
Looked like he was putting him over the ropes there, like tying him up in the ropes. I thought...
Maybe elimination over there between Chief Drew.
Yeah,
might
good
get
call.
Elimination there.
Hammerstone's in trouble
Hammerstone
here.
Hammerstone might go out here. Same with Marty. No, not yet. Already still in, but he might get the boot.
Yeah, locking up with Lance Archer is probably the dumbest thing Skrull could do going into this next to, the bar incident. But, Archer in control here on Hammerstone. Maybe not for long. It's just hard to call
Hammerstone it. Hammerstone against the turnbuckle there. It's an easy elimination.
Yeah, I'll make this a bit easier to call right now. Who's your pick to win this? Probably Archer, right? I would assume.
Archer or Marty.
Entry number 6, though, might change your mind, is the Alchemy Fear. Legend known as Fear. Enters Fear into the match here. Fear coming out representing Alchemy Wrestling. Of course, Alchemy just had their final show, the Pursuit 5 special. Of course, Fear is about to move on. He got signed to NXT, but making one final appearance here in UWA is Fear.
So monstrous in size.
Yeah, he's a bit terrifying too, but of course someone like Lance Archer, the Murder Hawk monster. Well, okay, he's a bit terrifying to Lance Archer, let's put it that way.
Maybe just a hair.
Yeah, I don't think Archer knows quite what to make of him.
Stuck on the ropes there. You need to fix those ropes. Get on that, man.
Yeah, well, it ain't my show, like I said, this is Ben's, but it was his idea
I'll
to put the sand.
Maybe I'll try to fix him when I get in there.
You're actually going to get in there?
Kenny Omega!
Omega is entry number 7 here. You were advertised for it, but I don't know if you can compete for it. But nonetheless, Kenny Omega entering at number 7 here. Of course, the current reigning AEW World Champion, the cleaner Kenny Omega. Is he your favorite now going into this, or is it still Lance Archer, the Murder Hawk Monster?
It's a tough choice here, but I'm still going to go with Lance, either Lance or Marty.
Yeah, we're seeing a strong showing of AEW here tonight in this match. It's Kenny Omega.
Sure.
He's making his entrance here. Yeah, Kenny Omega, Lance Archer.
Orange Cassidy was here earlier, but...
And Orange. Orange left
he
when
left
his buddy
when,
Parker died.
Yep, when Parker was murdered.
Basically. Got pounced all the way out of the ring. I mean, at least Parker got a spot on the show. But, I don't know if he's saying that right now. I don't know if he's saying much of anything.
Well, Probably not, he's probably still scared to death.
Kenny Omega showing off here. Wait a second, Hammerstone! Chief Drew with the third elimination of the match. Of course, Lance Archer getting the first two.
Right.
It's the first elimination we've seen in a minute.
I was gonna say Drew got three eliminations. I'm like, who? I was like, wait a minute, did I miss something?
Hammerstone and his imaginary dynasty. Ooh. Anyways, Archer now out of the corner here, going after Marty Skrull's arm.
Fear is against the turnbuckle there, but he gets out of the turnbuckle with the reversal. Lance Archer coming down hard on Marty Skrull there.
Yeah, we still argue if Lance Archer's probably the favorite just based on what we've seen so far. Real fake Batman's rearranging Kenny Omega right now, to my surprise. But nonetheless, entry number eight.
There comes Freeze. Chief Drew is trying to get somebody out over there. I'm forgetting who it was.
We'll see when we get back, hopefully.
Switch over to Freeze.
Yeah, Freeze, of course, making his entry number 8. Of course, the official entrance. I guess Ben isn't counting Parker and Vaquero. I am, but nonetheless, so Freeze technically is entry number 10. But nonetheless, Fear now. It was Fear, apparently, that Fear is trying to eliminate. RF Batman now in trouble with the hands.
RF Batman might go by Marty Skrull.
The villain trying.
He's just lifting him up and down. What the fuck are you doing, Marty Skrull?
He's having trouble eliminating this kid, but nonetheless.
Fear might go out here. Freeze might get some Fear.
Yeah,
what
oh,
I mean by RF Batman and Fear is gone.
Well, Fear's off to NXT now. See you later, buddy, but nonetheless, of course.
See you next time.
If there is a next time. Either way, right. Thank you, Fear. Bye-bye.
Freeze is against the ropes. Lance Archer might get his third elimination by himself.
That should be his fourth. Wait, no, it would be third. I was thinking Archer eliminated Fear. But
Kenny Omega.
Freeze now with two eliminations in a row. My bad. I almost credited him. And Drew got rid of someone. I think Batman. Yeah, Batman's
Freeze
out.
Freeze got Batman, I believe, right?
Drew. Drew got Batman. Freeze got Omega. Right? Because, yeah, Marty's still in here.
Here comes Alpha Beta.
This is getting confusing
as
shit.
My best friend.
Your best friend's coming out at entry number 11, technically.
Nine.
Technically 11, but yeah. The Archer throws, yeah, Ben's fucked up the count already. I mean, he is running production, which is probably not the best idea. This is for Ben's first show he ran by himself.
Get your hands off of her, Lance! Don't do this! Don't do this! No!
Everybody dies! Jimmy Quality's a bitch, and right there,
Oh my god, I feel so bad for Alpha Beta right now. You know what? I'm gonna give her my spot.
What? You're sitting in the back right there?
I'm giving her my spot. I'm sending her back out there. She's going to show Lance what feels like to be thrown over the top rope.
Whatever number you got, I guess, will be Alpha Beta's second entry now. She's the second person ever to enter the Rumble twice. The first person who did it didn't do it legally, so Alpha Beta will technically be the first person to legally enter twice. She's also, speaking of making history, she's also the first ever female to enter a Rumble for UWA, so take that into account, too.
Oh, my God.
Archer.
Jesus.
Archer has how many eliminations now? 4, I believe.
I think 4, yeah. Beta, 4.
Murderhawk Monster is just destroying everyone.
Just waiting for someone to eliminate him.
Yeah, I don't
Come
know.
Come on, Lance, get Chief Drew. He's been the longest. Besides
and here
you,
comes my uncle.
Leaf
entering at the next number, number 12 technically, but we'll just go with what's on the screen. So Leaf entering at number 10. Here, Leaf making his way out to the ring. Ben, you might want to fix the freaking count, you idiot. But nonetheless, Leaf. He probably won't. He probably don't even hear me right now. He's probably not even there. But anyways, Leaf now back in the end of the ring here. I should say not back in the ring, but.
Get up, Marty. Chief Drew is against the turnbuckle again, and Chief Drew is gone.
Archer now up to 5 eliminations here. Lance Archer just cleaning house. Of course, you can't forget Archer entered at number 2.
Oh, what a maneuver there by Marty.
That's the Ghostbuster.
What is going on with Chief Drew over there? What the fuck is going on with Chief Drew?
I think Drew's knees a bit messed up.
Out.
Anyways, Marty.
Some water, Drew.
Marty stayed in control.
My, what a throw there by Lance.
It's not a good thing either, because Drew's supposed to have a match later tonight against the inmates. It was a Book T's wish. Oh God! What the hell's going on? It's Doohop! It's Doohop from Grimm's Toy Show. He just laid out real fake Batman. Why the hell did he give a spot to Doohop?
I mean, honestly, I think he deserves a spot more than real fake Batman.
That is probably true, but Doohawk telling us to eat it, yeah, as he makes his way down to the ring here representing D-Generation Fat, of course, is Doohawk. The older brother of Glenn.
I want to see how long this guy lasts. I don't think he's going to last very long. Seems too cocky. Way too cocky.
That's your only clue there. Doohawk making his way into the ring. He's going right after Free.
There goes Marty. Your uncle looks like, yeah, your uncle just eliminated Marty.
Yeah, well, I think Leaf just definitely made a face turn then. But Marty Skrull is out of
Drew
the way
is
here.
Still fucking, oh my God.
Maybe Marty will help him out there.
Marty's the same way, I think. Yep. Jake, no.
Drew, I think, just went into the crowd. But, no, Doohawk!
There he goes! I knew it! I told you.
Oh no, and Freeze!
There goes Freeze! Down to your uncle and Lance right here.
Yeah,
what is going on with Marty now? Everybody gonna be so nominated over there is like spazzing out. I don't know if there's some hot chick over there. I don't know.
This is not the Lance that Leaf would want to be in the ring with. It's now entry number 12. It happens to be the Lit World Champion, Riley Saint. Saint making a future.
Not only is the year of now, but this guy is really, really talented.
He might be the future challenger of the UWA Intercontinental Championship against Bertie Lee, his former connection brother, if he can win here tonight. It's going to be easier said than done, though, stepping in the ring with someone like the Murderhawk Monster, Lance Archer.
Get
part
away from that
12-year-old
over there. He might be
something. Oh, God. Archer's... Oh, Riley Saint from behind a Lance Archer. I think they're a little too young for Marty. And right there, a nice counter there from Leaf.
You gotta keep an eye on Marty over there.
Marty prefers the ones that can barely drive. But nonetheless, Leaf in control now on Riley Saint. Oh God, the mountain man stomp there from Leaf on the Lit World Champion Riley Saint right into an execution.
That's a DDT.
Got to put over Edge. Leaf's a fellow Canadian. And now the clock counts
Lance
down here.
Lance against the ropes. Can
oh my God.
For Lance?
If Leaf, oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh my God. Here comes Flip Gordon.
My uncle just eliminated Lance Archer.
And Lance had 5 eliminations, I believe?
6. Before he was out, Freeze got him up to 6.
6, yep.
Pretty impressive. That, I think, is the second most in UWA history. If this was a technically Universal Rumble, it's not, but it's a SoCal Rumble. They made sure to make that apparent. But nonetheless, Flip Gordon, because of course he thinks everything's better in SoCal, speaking of Mark.
Well, that explosion was better than AEW's explosion.
Anyways, Flip Gordon making his way down to the ring. Flip's got more pyro than Tony Khan. Take that, Tony. Now Flip Gordon in
control. Is that Kenny Omega still fooling around over there? What?
Apparently Omega decided not to ever go to the back.
Well, maybe he was getting some ideas for the next explosion for AEW. I don't know.
Shit. My fucking side hurts now. Like, we say in control of Flint Gordon. What the fuck?
Is Alpha Beta back in the ring?
I guess. What fucking entry were you? I guess you took your spot finally. This is fucking gone
crazy.
Man's
fucking this shit up, bro. I lost track. Where's your uncle?
That's what I was about to say. Lee's on the outside somewhere resting. Edward Drake now coming out as the next entrant. Oh, we're all good, man. Leaf slid back in the ring now. Like, yeah, he was just taking a break, man. He was taking
a water break.
Yeah, you know, it takes a lot out of you to eliminate someone like Lance Archer. Plus, I mean, all the sand, you know, is soaking all the water out of the competitors, right? Like, that kind of does that, right? Maybe not. Anyways, Edward Drake making his way into the ring here, and the Leafs hop right back out of the ring.
Yep, I was like, where's Leaf?
You know, you see, I actually gave him this idea, and it was a very good idea. I'm just going to put that out there.
Kinda, I guess. There goes Alpha Beta. Oh, damn it. I gave her two chances and she fucks
them
up. Jesus.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you put a chick in there against a bunch of guys, just saying.
I guess so.
Gender equality here. Well, nice try, Alpha Beta. Why don't you go beat on your husband some more, you cunt? I probably shouldn't say that. Boot might get mad. And now Flip in control here.
Oh my, what a kick.
Yeah,
straight
I heard
to the face, I believe.
I heard Brute Payne likes to beat Alpha with a salmon, and I'm not sure how true that is, but Flip Gordon in control right now, and Edward Drake.
I don't get into that kind of shit.
And Brandon Pickett was bringing that up on his stream.
Adam Cole, baby!
There, a nice counter, Saint in control on Flip Gordon, and of course, the leader of the Undisputed Era, well, formerly the leader of the Undisputed Era, NXT's own Flip, NXT's own Adam Cole. I missed the Adam Cole Bay Bay Q too. I'm really fucking up tonight. Ever since that stupid King Omega line.
I did the Bay Bay Q.
Oh, I did it before you showed up.
That was my shtick. I'm back off.
That was my shtick. And now Lee's finally got back in the ring.
Right. Wait, wasn't there more than...
No, because remember Alpha Beta just got eliminated.
Okay, yeah.
And now,
he's
in control on Adam Cole.
A DVD there.
And no kidding, Edward Drake on Riley Saint here. Saint's still in the match, surprisingly. He's lasted quite a bit of time.
Speaking of Saint.
Might be in trouble here at the hands of Edward Drake of Synergy. Drake's got him over the ropes.
He might hang on.
What? Oh, Cole, no!
Oh,
shit.
Man, a knee straight to the back of the head of your uncle.
Screw
goodbye,
you, Adam.
Leaf.
Come on, Leaf, hold on. Yes, Leaf's holding on. I'm putting my uncle over this time.
Here comes Lee Harris.
Entry number 18, of course, is diehard Dylan Harris's son, Lee Harris. As Adam Cole is in trouble, come on, Leaf, eliminate him. He didn't eliminate him. And Lee Harris now walking up with Synergies.
Did Lee Harris lose weight or something? I remember him being a big man with that guy. I don't know.
What?
Fucking know what I'm talking about.
No, Lee Harris, the son. Oh, God, he's going for the patented Harris lion salt here off the ropes.
Oh,
nicely done.
A kick straight to the face of Riley Saint there. Your uncle might be in trouble, though.
Yeah, he's not in trouble. We can handle Adam Cole. Come on, Leaf.
Baby.
Yeah, nonetheless, Edward Drake. Oh, God, just rearranged the facial features of Lee Harris. Of course,
that's
Lee Harris.
Coming out.
Brody Lee's godson. So he would love nothing more than to win this match. And... Fuck. Wait for it. By God, King, it's gotta be Kane.
Well, I've got a new favorite.
the Big Red Machine Kane. Of course, he sees no evil in this match. And it's too bad Lance Archer wasn't in this still, because that would make a very interesting matchup here between the Murderhawk Monster and the Big Red Machine Kane.
What a maneuver there by Riley.
Yeah, is Riley going to try to step up to the Devil's Favorite Demon? Yeah, I wouldn't either. Oh, come on, Lee. Really? That was your big bright plan to freaking lock up with
your
Kane?
Your uncle might be gone.
Oh, God. Yeah, well, I wouldn't count on it earlier,
there
but I would
goes.
Count on it now, and yeah, there's good Leafs out. Big Red Machine Kane, it didn't take him
Riley
too long to limit
Riley's really
Leaf.
Showing up here. Really showing up.
Yeah, we've got, of course.
He's been there the longest, happy.
Out of the people in here currently, yes. Now, Edward Drake trying to eliminate
oh,
Kane.
God. Don't even try it.
Which
Drake.
Is, yeah,
no,
that's a
no.
dumb idea. And,
Riley Saint catching the leg there.
If Saint's got any brains, he'll try to work together with every. Oh, God, Saint with that step up rising high knee to Adam Cole. Adam Cole might be out after that payday.
Here comes MVP.
UWA legend Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP. Of course, one of the agents in the back here for UWA is making his way down to the ring for this matchup. You're not in the SoCal Rumble. MVP is supposed to be retired, but he's coming out of retirement here for a match, or at least for an entry in the Rumble.
No Kane.
No Kane.
Got a Kane with him last night, I guess.
He's
better now.
Homemade. And
no,
right,
he walks the cane on Raw.
On what? Shut up. And there goes Adam Cole, courtesy of
there
Lee Harris and Riley Saint. Fuck that show. Nonetheless, Kane.
This show's much better.
Yeah, there you go. Okay, finally Riley Saint doing the smart thing that I told him to do. And freaking, oh, now Lee Harris turned his back on Riley
Lee
Saint
Harris,
here.
Nope.
Former Connection Brothers.
Lee Harris is going to pay for that.
Yeah, former Connection Brothers, not going to work together too well.
Oh, what an enziguri.
Edward
there
Drake's
went
out.
Edward Drake.
Courtesy of Montel Vontavious Porter.
Oh, there goes
shit.
The Saint. Riley Saint.
That was an upset elimination right there. Lee Harris taking advantage
oh,
of that.
Oh, yeah. Kane just threw a like a freaking ragdoll there.
Yeah, Kane is
now Lee
easily
Harris.
Defeated.
Oh, man. Uh-oh.
Wait a minute.
What is going on?
Wait a minute. Wait one damn minute. Oh my God.
This can't be. Tell me this is not who I think it is.
Forever of Movements. Oh my God, it's it's BH, it's Black Aaron, the leader of Betrayal from FAM, Forever of Movements, Black Aaron. BH making his way out of the ring here.
The crowd has erupted.
Of course, Black Aaron, a member of the biggest organization in the universe, Forever of Movement Wrestling. Of course, now labeled Unite, but nonetheless, the former world champion, multi-time world champion, the leader of Betrayal, Black Aaron, BH, is making his way out to the ring here. I would argue now the tides have turned for the SoCal Rumble. Kane and Black Aaron in the ring here together. That's going to be the matchup here to move on, I would argue. Taking nothing away from MVP.
Did he take Kane's mask?
Fuck Kane's mask. Shut up. I'm gonna want that fucking fruit roll-up mask anyway.
He took Kane's mask and messed it up a little bit.
Oh, I'm gonna kill you. Black Aaron making his way into the ring, dude. Enough of the Kane's mask bullshit. Trying to put over Cena Evil Kane right now. And Kane off the ropes here. MVP in control on Lee Harris. Black Aaron going right after... Oh, my
oh,
God!
Oh, there is Kane! DH already eliminates Kane there.
Within a few seconds, Kane's eliminated by Black Heron. I was expecting that to be a good match up there, but BH just told Kane
said
to go fuck himself. Maybe he did steal Kane's mask. And you seen there, Lee Harris shoved MVP right into Black Heron, which is going to hit the Black Hammer.
Oh, wow, what a jackhammer.
Right there, yeah, BH's jackhammer's patented move. And of course, alongside the black and gold powerbomb.
Get your ass goodbye, Lee Harris.
Lee Harris is in trouble here at the hands of BH and MVP talking
MVP
there.
MVP ballin'! Not no more.
Yeah, Montel Vontavious Porter is a UWA legend, but he might want to slow his roll there.
Here comes his brother X.
Yes, one of Max Fatal's good buddies from his independent days. He has recently got a contract here in UWA. They're old friends, they haven't seen each other in quite some time. But Bubba X making his way into the ring. He is the 22nd and final entrant in this match. Good luck, Bubba X.
So we're down to the final three.
MVP,
Bubba X, and the
other guy. Black Heron. A nice counter there from MVP. Kicks him in the midsection. Who the hell's going to move on here to be to challenge?
Ropes.
Oh God!
Bye, MVP. Two big men. Final two.
Bubba X, Black Heron.
Man, Bubba X going. BH against the ropes. Can he go?
What an upset this would be if Bubba X can eliminate Black Heron.
Oh! Uh oh. He's still there. No.
BH fighting back in.
How did Bubba X hurt his knee there? What the hell?
I don't know, X grabbing his knee. I think he realizes it's down to him and BH. And BH sends him off the ropes, pops him up. Oh, God.
Oh,
Black and
God.
Gold. Black and gold power bomb out of the ring.
BH is your winner.
Black Heron, the former leader of Betrayal, will be going on to challenge Intercontinental Champion Connection brother Brody Lee. Tonight on the main show here for the Intercontinental Championship of the Universal Wrestling Alliance. What a matchup that's going to be. Black Heron one-on-one with the champ. And nonetheless, we're putting on some pyro here for Black Heron. Yet again, we still have more pyro than
AEW.
But nonetheless, yeah, I'm just rib AEW.
Are you doing?
All night, every night.
Anyways, we are moving on here. What? Oh my God!
What
is
the
that?
Hell?
That's Penance. That dirty bastard, Penance. And he's going after all our Batman.
Gonna unmask him. Do it! Do it, Penance!
Oh my
Do
God!
It.
He just ripped Batman's mask off.
Let's see it. Let's see who it is.
Of course, Penance is doing this because he's going to be facing Nitro at the top of the hour here to start the show, and Nitro's mask is going to be on the line. Penance is, oh my, is that? It's fucking Justin Bieber. You've got to be fucking kidding me.
What? What?
That's the lamest reveal of all time. Oh, thank you, Penance.
Very lame.
For nothing, as Penance.
Would have been a better Batman than Justin Bieber there.
Well, no shit, Penance will be going one-on-one with Nitro at the start of SoCal Showdown. The dirty bastard Penance from Cologne, Germany, looking to do his favorite thing ever and unmask Nitro. Well, he's going to have to wait to the top of the hour here for the show for SoCal Showdown. If Nitro loses, he's going to be forced to reveal his face.
Who do you got for that match, Matt? Who are you picking?
Well, I hope the hell Nitro wins, but based on the current situation, your Penance seems to be on fire.
He doesn't seem to be on fire. He seems to be angry. And angry Penance isn't
fire.
Good for anyone.
Yeah, but
what the fuck?
Drew's coming back out here. This was not scheduled for the show,
it's
but
cheap,
.
Drew, you little bastard.
Yeah, okay. Chief Drew. Nothing new to argue right now. I don't even know why you're arguing because, I mean, your knee's fucked up. So literally all I'd have to do is, like, kick you in the shin right now and you'd fall over. But
why is he coming out with Bambi? What the fuck?
I don't know. We haven't seen Manny in a while. Drew seemed pretty upset back at Jailbreak, though. I'm not exactly sure why, but we never figured out. But Drew seemed a bit upset when he was brought into his office to check something out on the surveillance. Of course, that was when he found out the inmates were busted out of the asylum after the explosion. But yeah, I don't know why Drew's out here.
Maybe it has something to do with Mammy.
Yeah, that's a pretty good guess. Of course, Mammy, the mother of Ryback, the big guy. You haven't seen him in a minute either.
Hell of a woman that girl is.
Ew. Anyway.
Giving birth to Ryback, that's what I mean.
Oh, okay.
Ryback's a tough son of a bitch.
Yeah, he's got a big head, too.
I didn't say
that. Now, I know I wasn't successful earlier. The prisoners have escaped. And hell, I even got a fight book tonight. But those problems pale in comparison to the issue I've come out to address here this evening. A great man once known as Jay-Z once said, "I've got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one." Well, he was a lucky bastard because I take 99 problems over your skank ass. Mammy, I seen the picture. We're done. And I'll be arresting your fat asses for bribing a public officer.
Oh! He just punched Mammy!
Holy shit!
Same hell?
What the fuck?
You are shitting me.
Is that?
Okay.
Who the fuck is that?
That can't be who I think it is.
No, but, oh god, there's a freaking fight with swords out here on the. What the hell is going on?
Beach? Yeah, they're on the beach. I don't know what's going on, man.
Of course, that's the beach right outside the venue, and. Oh my god, he's entered the ring. This is. Is that Ryback?
What?
It almost
there's no
looks
way.
Like Ryback.
It does look like Ryback, but there's no way.
Ryback's never been that much of a badass. The hell? He just killed someone.
Through a beard, baby.
We haven't seen Ryback in
long beard.
We haven't seen Ryback in 6 months. We haven't seen him since he was lost in time. I can only imagine Drew's in trouble though, he just did Ryback's Mammy. That is a wee bit fucked up in my opinion, even if she is a whore. No offense, of course.
That is Ryback.
And he's acting all weird though, I don't know what the hell is going on here. Damn, Ryback's music either, what the heck? I don't know how the hell Ben freaking stayed good. And now Ryback yelling at Drew. Dude, Ryback does not seem too happy. What? He just laid out his own mom.
He laid out his own mammy.
Oh my god,
give
that was mountainous. Oh, I probably shouldn't have said it that way, but nonetheless, Ryback just beat the crap out of Mammy. Ryback just raining down fists on
just
freaking.
Just like the fans say, holy shit.
I mean, it's not too out of the realm of possibility. Ryback did bang Ronda, his freaking stepsister, so. And now Ryback's got Mammy up. What the hell is he?
Shell shock!
You've got to be kidding me. Why?
Oh, he probably just broke her back. That had to have broken her back.
I'm sure Drew's broken her back on several occasions. I don't think Ryback gives a shit. Now Drew's...
Oh, man.
He's just going to allow this.
Oh, man. Somebody get out there and help her.
Well, I can't say she didn't deserve this, but,
well,
according to Drew, sure she is a cheating, what did he say, skank ass, something like that. Nonetheless, yeah. Evan Rude, if you're wondering, there's the picture Drew was referring to. Mammy with iced tea. She's just completely fucked, in my opinion.
Wow. And
anyways, right. Moving
what
on.
What is this?
What, Brute, what
What's
are you
doing? Oh, shit!
Brute, what the hell are you doing? He's injured. Brute, knock it the fuck off, dude. Like, I don't even know what. Brute, knock it off, you fucking asshole. Dude, come on. Oh no, not the table, not the table. I paid 10 bucks for that thing at fucking Goodwill. No.
You put my wife in danger twice, you son of a bitch. I'm going to string you up and gut you like an old monkey from back in the
monkey,
old country.
You can't say that, Brute, you fucking idiot. What the hell are you doing? Monkey, what kind of fucking shit is this?
Shut up, Matt, before I beat your face in two. My wife was chokeslammed.
Okay, anyways, I'm gonna go get the doctor. Brute, you fucking lost your mind. This can't even be legal. Play your stupid ad right now for pain apparel. I'm getting the fuck out of here. Doctor, can I get a doctor?
Hey, everyone. Brute Payne here. Need some new clothes because yours are still stuck in 2020? Well, get pain apparel today. We have t-shirts, jackets, hats, scarves, and more. Look as strong as the old country when you wear Brute Payne's Pain Apparel. Half off every holiday. Shop Pain Apparel right now, because there's nothing more painful than having an awful wardrobe. Oh no.
What the Garrett, what the hell are you doing back here? I'm trying to find a doctor. You know where the doctor is?
Thank you for the introduction, numbnuts, but next time, stay on script. I told you beautiful California. Alright? Don't make me hurt you. Now, what to do next? Could waste everyone's time like Lance. So, why don't you four give me the cases, hand them over, and let's get this party started.
Watching all your fans.
Macho, you already know, man, he's a Mayan god. Adam Page, he's Macho's best friend.
He just won the match, he's gonna pin Aleister Black, and for the ricochet! With the five-star save at the very last second. But he's just taking himself out. Macho slid in the fallout.
Andre Santos just slid in from behind and fucked Aleister's day up.
Come on, Paige. Don't do this. You know this isn't what's best for the connection.
I know. But I have to do this, Macho. I know you don't understand, but this is my company.
And the connection is our club. Don't choose UWA over us. This is me telling you not to do this.
KSJ with a chair out of nowhere to Adam Page. Speaking of the shits, here comes Macho Santos, my best friend, my Instagram friend. Here comes Macho Santos. What? Oh no! What the hell? That's Ryan Steele and is that Edward Drake?
You, not us. It's all your fault. You killed the connection.
Yes! Yes! That's the music of Macho Santos. Yes! Maybe Ice will take care of him. And now Santos just tosses KSJ up into the air. DT comes in the fallout to Graven Tully. In for the cover. Come on, Santos. KSJ on the top.
He made it.
Breaks
it
up.
In time.
Fuck you, KSJ. You piece of shit. Come on, Santos. No, it wasn't. Oh, God. High knee. Oh, God. Divine intervention from DT. Santos is still up. Oh no, the switch off!
You thought Macho was gonna be the hometown hero, right?
He is!
The hero of UWA!
What the
Macho!
Hell?
Macho!
No!
That's the costume.
He's Macho's best friend.
Fucking Macho Santos, baby!
Why would he do that? Stop it, Santos! No.
Break him in half, Macho!
You son of a bitch!
This is all your fault. I told you weren't putting in the connection first.
What kind of fucking man does
Not
that?
Not once. He attacked him twice. Macho Santos has left the building.
Right here. Looks like you went
place that.
Oh, shit.
He's won the trick out of his own book.
No.